power to the truth. Ultimately, we are here to make a difference in the world, to make it a better world. We may not be able to get rid of all the pastor's pigs and destroy evil in the world. So let's not start a war on evil like the failed U.S. war on terror. We've got to remember that we must also work on the evil within us and know you're not all good, but neither are you all evil. Not even Hitler was all evil, but we like to use him as an incarnation of evil. Not even Cheney is all evil. So no one is all evil or all good. We all have the potential for good or evil in our lives. And we need to be realistic and understand that. And words are weird because words can mean different things to different people. You know, what is good? What is evil? So our definitions about words can vary with our individual interpretations. To me, what promotes life, what sustains life, what prospers life, is good. And that which destroys life, stunts life, kills life, is evil. So we're looking at real good and real evil. Some people are so burned out that they don't even want to think about there are actually evil people in the world, you know, as if that's just a value judgment. Yet when someone is like, say, joins the U.S. Army and then gets involved in fighting imperialist wars overseas and kills people and trains to kill people, that to me is an evil person. So when we seek to combat evil in the world, we must also remember that those who are U.S. soldiers who participate in evil must also be criticized. We do not live in an ideal world. We do not live in a world where our highest ideals about truth and justice and harmony are in control. Nowadays, it's as if, you know, we've lost contact with God. And in a way, our God is money. M-O-N-E-Y. We judge the value of a person in terms of how much money they have, not in terms of their spiritual values. And even the word spiritual is vague. What is spiritual? You know, there's good spirits and there's bad spirits. And we have a way of, we try to split the universe, we try to split the cosmos by saying good and evil. You know, left wing, right wing, red state, blue state. When we need both in a way to compare, to have standards of judgment. Now, I believe that the Holy Bible, which the word Bible means the book of books, and somewhere in there it says that I created good and evil. So, I think it's good to study the Holy Bible, but not to get fixated on just one scripture and then apply that to all policies and all issues and get fanatical. Same thing with the Quran. You know, have you read the Quran? You know, it's good to at least scan through it. And we need to express ourselves. As we express ourselves without fear, without worrying about stepping on anyone's toes, without being obsessed with offending anyone, and knowing that no matter what you say or do, people are still going to talk shit. So you know what? While you're here on Earth, make a difference, express yourself, be a warrior in the fight for justice and truth and decency. Let's check again. 7:46 or something. Anyway, many people they live their lives out, you know, going along with the program, and history will not even know they existed. Which I think is kind of sad. I wish my father, for example, would have, you know, he's well living in West Sac in the good home right now. But I wish he would have left videos. And I wish my grandparents would have left videos, and my great-grandparents. So I encourage you to express yourselves while you can, and think of your descendants, those who will come after you, and leave something behind so they know that you passed through. I believe that much of our history has been lost, especially among indigenous people, among Chicanos, you know, with the conquest of the Spaniards in Mexico. And remember that a conquering people tries to eliminate proof of a people's history, of the people that they have conquered or they're oppressing. So leave with history that you can, and express yourself and share with others so that we know that you came through. And if you look at what you gain and what you lose, to me, a lot of what, this is my individual, personal, subjective trip here, is that all the stuff that I lost, I think losing pictures that I had, and one when I was an infant, and one with my mom and other people, and then I was homeless and had to move in a left-up box in the garage somewhere, and shit happens. So, take pictures while you can. Take videos while you can. And preserve those as part of your family history album. The part of your proof that you were alive. And wake up every day to a brand new day of having the capacity to express yourself.